I quit my job, founded my own company. So that the ability to write gave me, even in corporate life, and I rose. This is one aspect. There can be other benefits as well. To become a star, notice you better, people will connect with you. So corporate life today, networking, and this gives you an opportunity, people want to network with you. So this is the second aspect.
Okay, so very well said. So you say, there's an interesting point that you are making. Writing led to making more networks for you, right?
Yes, sir. Writing made the network stronger, wider, and even made me rise faster.
That's an interesting stuff. So now can we talk a little more on then how writing shaped your life? So yeah. you are saying, you know, it helped you to connect with other people and also to widen your network. And it helped you rise up in your career faster. So those three aspects, I think this is very interesting, right? So say for example, as a technologist, how can I use writing to connect to people and to widen my network and to rise up in my career?
Very right. Well figured. So, is it a question or is it just a statement?
No. This is a question. Like you said, these three things happened because of writing. So can you elaborate how, can you give me certain examples, basically?
As far as I can understand your question, it means he utilized these. You see, today it is not one single skill that makes one successful. So different kinds of also to rise in your career, and writing is such a skill which connects you to people. Number one, it makes your thought process also clear. Now, when I start writing, there are so many ideas in my mind. I have to decide on certain ideas that I am going to put in this particular article or this particular note or whatever I am writing over there. So that makes even my mind clear. That clears my thought process also. I can think strategically and I can communicate strategically. If I am not an author, if I am not a writer, I may confuse others. I may get confused and I may confuse others also. But when I am a writer, I will write strategically, I will write clearly, and I will convey clearly. Communication is today the most required skill set that is required. And since, because of the lockdown, we are working remotely, most of us are working remotely. So it is only the communication that connects us with the other person. So if you can either write better or speak better, you will definitely connect better and you will rise. So this is one thing. Second thing I would like to say, as you said, being a technology person, if you want to rise, what will you do? So it's a very good example in my career. Since we are a public relations company and we cater to various kinds of clients. So one of our clients is a dental chain. So doctor writes other doctors. The audience profile you need to map always whenever you are writing. If a doctor is writing, if a dentist is writing to other dentists, he will use the word mandible. But if he is writing the same thing to me, he will use the word jaw instead of mandible. An eye specialist writing to another eye specialist will say ocular infection. But a person, when he is talking to a patient, he will say eye infection. So you need to always map the audience profile and you will communicate accordingly. That will your ideas clear to the other person, that will make your ideas understandable to the other person. So if you understand this thing, anybody can rise better.
This is a very good tip. You need to understand whom you are talking to, who you are writing to, and then change the words and change the jargons. Because as an employee, one time I might be talking to my own peers.
Exactly.
One time I might be talking to a CEO.
Yeah.
Another time I might be talking to my customer.
Yeah.
So the words that I choose in these different contexts makes me a good communicator, and I'm a writer. Okay, so that's a good tip. And the example that you gave is also very relevant, and it can stick with us. So which is now to start? Yeah. Did you have any training in writing, or can anybody start writing? Let's say for example, I know about Darshan and Sarang. They are probably having about 5 year experience now in IT industry. Can they start writing today?
Yeah. Yes, anybody can start writing anytime, any point in time. I'll give you 2-3 simple examples. This entire conversation is in English. It means everybody in the audience has academic qualifications. He or she has passed certain exams. And if you have passed even matriculation, you are writing answers to questions to pass the exam.
Correct.
You are choosing your words. You are having your own expression over there. So we've been writing since the first day of our academic career. One thing. Second thing, we daily send SMSs to our friends. We write something. We send WhatsApp messages to our friends. We write something. We send emails to our peers, friends, colleagues, seniors, juniors, whosoever. We are writing. So it's a mental perception. People don't understand that they are writing already. They don't need a specific thing. Is being mentally alert that they are writing and keep reading and ideas write. It is as simple as that. It is said that if you think you can do something, you will do that thing. If you think you can't do that thing, you can't do that thing. You are right both ways. So it is only a mental perception that either makes you go ahead or blocks your way.
Okay, so what you are saying is, whether we realize or not, we are already writers.
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah. Writers.
Okay, so now having established that we are all writers, and we are all writing in one form or the other, and I'm going back to the previous answer you gave, and you said, When I come to write, I have way too many things in my mind. I need to declutter my mind. And this is a problem that most of us face. And I was talking to Nitin, who is here. I was talking to Nitin, and he mentioned the same problem.
Yeah.
Hey, you know what? I want to write something. I will probably, it could be an email that I'm sending to my boss, email I'm sending it to my peer, or a LinkedIn article that I'm writing, or my blog article that I'm writing. When I want to write on a topic, and let me give an example. Okay. Say for example, how to write a good email to your colleague. Now my mind is cluttered with so many things. How do I put that out in a proper form? How do I express my thoughts in a way that the other person will understand?
Good question. Very good question. And I'm happy that a person who is facing this challenge is here. I welcome Mr. Nitin specifically for putting up this question to you. And I would like to answer as I can. I generally use a Loyn formula. LION. The Loyn formula says learn. First thing is you keep on reading. whichever domain you are in, if you want to write on technology, you should read the technology blogs, technology publications, technology magazines. You will come to know what other people are writing. This is one thing. Second is I means innovate. Now, in writing, the way you can innovate is in corporate life. We say if you face a problem, you can bundle things and unbundle things. Now, I'll give you an example. If you read one article which has five ideas, you can unbundle it, choose just one idea and go into depth of that particular idea, elaborate on that particular idea. It is unbundling. And if you have read 10 articles with 10 different point of view, you can write another article where you can assimilate all those ideas. So you have bundled those ideas in a different way, adding your own point of view, adding your own expression, adding your own experience of the life. And this is how you come up with new things. This is, okay. This is one thing. You either group or regroup. This is one thing. Second thing is, what I have been doing is, if you are reading an article, just notice the headline and think, what can you write according to that headline? So instead of reading the article first, just note down the ideas. If you wanted to write on that particular, with that particular headline, what will you write? This will give you many ideas. And when you read the article, you think, what is the headline you would have given to that particular article? So both ways, you can learn and you can develop your skill. So I believe Mr. Nitin can do this very easily, and it is very simple. I'm a jugaad kind of person. I'm not that academically qualified. So I use simple jugaads in life so that things become easier for me.
Okay. Thank you, Kranjit. Thanks, Joseph, also for picking up this thing. I really appreciate that. So I'm noting down LOIL, right? Learn and innovate, please.
Yes, sir. And in N, I forgot to, very good, you talked and you reminded me, I forgot to explain the N part of the formula. N is network. So you network with people. Could you please now mute yourself, please? Yeah, so that we can continue with the conversation. N is networking. Everybody today says network, network, network. I applied it in a different thing. I checked my list of contacts and I all contacts which I did not talk for last 5 years. I did not even know who they are. They are not relevant to me. I am not relevant to them. If we have not talked during last 5 years, they are not my network. And if you want to have the relevant network, you should have the network, but you should have the relevant network as well. And if you want to have the relevant network, you should first unclutter yourself. This is all clutter. If you have 40,000 contacts in your phone book, it is just occupying space. It is just occupying your hard disk in the phone. So it is better to have 2,000 contacts or 1,000 contacts who are relevant to you. And then you give opportunity to others who want to connect with you. There will be space. Unless you unclutter yourself, you can't have new people into your network. So to have new and relevant people in your network, you can't grow unless you keep on having new people in your network. So networking has a different meaning altogether if you unclutter yourself.
Okay, so I did not get the O. So L is for learn, I is for innovate, N is for network. What is about the O?
O is opportunity. Opportunity. Opportunity to meet people, opportunity to write better, opportunity to connect with people, opportunity to think in new ways. So opportunity has many kinds of opportunities. It is not just networking. It is not just writing. It has many dimensions.
Wonderful. I think this itself is a huge value. At least I have gotten it. So learn, innovate, opportunity, and network. Lion.
Yeah.
So writing makes you a lion.
Yeah.
Wonderful. And
writing makes one lion. Yeah.
I like this in innovate, so everybody talks about software eating the world. And in the software, we are always talking about bundling and unbundling. I never thought about using that for writing.
Great.
In that particular way, the Jugaad and whatever that you could call it as, you have brought that out into writing and saying, you know, you can dissect one particular article and write on your own, or you can combine multiple articles and write on your own, and so on and so forth. So I'm going to assume now people in this particular forum, I've been pushing Sarang and Niting and Darshan and Sajal to write on LinkedIn all the time. And Sajal has been continuous. She posts every day. But I hope Sarang and Niting, now you have your answer to write on everyday basis. Sarang and Niting, do you have any questions or anybody else? Mr. Pavan, anybody else, if you have any question? Mr. Jagan?
I'd like to add something.
Yes, please.
I'd like to add.
Please.
Like you said, lion, right? LION. O stands for opportunities. I write every day because 365 days, 365 opportunities. And that actually, you know, expands my horizon. Yeah. And every day, whenever somebody sees some poll, they might not even read it. But when they say Sejal Sood, there's going to be one day when they're going to Google my name. For sure. And eventually, that transforms a cold lead into a warm lead, and that further transforms a warm lead into a hot lead. And that might be a future client for me.
Yes.
Wonderfully said, Sajal. That's good. And what I realized, Kuranaji, is that, so this again kind of forms into a flywheel. I am very passionate and interested and enthusiastic about flywheel. And I teach that in my course.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So you learn. Yeah. And then learning helps you to innovate. And when you bundle and unbundle, it opens up new opportunities for you. And opportunity will expand into network. And that network will again help you learn more and give you more opportunities and so on and so forth. So this is a very interesting thing. Yeah. And it's very easy to remember also. We don't have to kind of think of so many different things. It's very easy. Lion, L-I-O-N. I'm very enthusiastic, very glad about this.
I have one question.
Everybody wants to be a lion. Please,
go ahead, sir.
Yeah, so this is really interesting way to write. Even in my earlier articles, I try to bundle up the things and try to put it in the way I thought about it. But when I completed and I publish my article, I always feel like about what are the mistakes? Like, did I do right? Did I do wrong? Is there a better way? Is there a wrong way? Is it something which I can improve on? Because there is, when you start writing, you don't have any feedback about it. So how should I go about this solving?
Yeah, this is a very good question.
I would like to give the example of Mr. Abraham Lincoln, whose speech which made history was rewritten 83 times. It was a 3-minute speech which was rewritten 83 times. So a person of his stature, if he revises his article, his speech 83 times, ponders over it, whatever you have published is a gold mine. You can revisit it, you can improve upon it. And when you have 10 articles, you can create another article from your own writings also. And you can write better, you can give even better concept. So revisiting your own articles is also a way of writing new articles and improving upon your thing it will improve your thinking also. It will make you think clearly, and you will, this is how practice makes a man perfect. If you keep on writing and rewriting and revisiting your own articles, you can see what the mistakes you had committed in the past, and next time when you write, you won't commit those same.
Very true. Very true. Sarang, one of the things that has worked for me,
I will only like to add what,
I'll finish this.
I would like to add one more thing.
There might be a lag. Let me finish.
Your voice has gone. Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
One of the things that has worked for me, like what Kuranaji is talking about, is I'll write something on the blog, then I'll go and write on the LinkedIn. And when I write on LinkedIn, probably my thought process is already neuro-connected, and I will rewrite the same concept, same idea in different words, different sentence formation. And then I will go and write in Twitter. Yeah. It'll be in a different formation. And every time I write, it's basically rewriting, right? I'm doing that, and I'm learning. And this is completely, I agree. I mean, whatever Mr. Kurana has said, and which I'm experiencing. Yes, Kuranaji, okay.
Add to what I said earlier, I will give two simple more tools that I keep on using for starters. It is for starters and for experienced writers also. So the first tool is, if you want to multiply your vocabulary, you can use prefixes and suffixes. This makes your vocabulary wider, and you don't need to remember the meaning and the spellings of the new word or the derivatives. Now, simple thing, there is a word depend. From depend, you have a derivative dependent. From depend, you have a derivative dependence. From dependence, you can have a derivative independence. So a normal man cannot think that depend and independence have the same root. If you understand the etymology and the prefixes and suffixes, you can enlarge your vocabulary meaningfully without having strained your mind. So this makes your job easier. This makes you understand the word better, and this makes you use the word in a better way, in a different way also. One thing. Second thing is, I use the emphasis principle. Emphasis principle is, now I will give you an example. If I want to talk about Mr. Joseph, I will say, if you want to learn clear thinking, strategic thinking, you should go to Mr. Joseph. But if I want to emphasize on strategic thinking, I'll say Mr. Joseph is the teacher who teaches strategic thinking. So the word you want to emphasize upon should be at the last of the sentence. This is a rule which captures your mind, subconscious mind. So if you want to emphasize a particular thing, it should come at the end of your sentence.
Wow. I'm going on writing. I'm taking notes. This is
another thing I want to say. Whenever I write, I don't write a news item. I don't write an article. I don't write something simple. I write always music. What do I mean by writing music is, if you have the first sentence which has, say, 5 words, the next sentence should have 12 words, different number of words. The next sentence should have different number of words. So your reading capability, it is not monotonous. It is like you are writing music. If you want to write good articles, you should have sentences of varied lengths always. It should not be monotonous. So this captures the reader's mind. And sometimes when you want to emphasize upon, you repeat the same word in different, using different words.
This is amazing.
So this is how we emphasize upon, and this is how we create music.
Wonderful, wonderful. Sarang and Nitin, I hope now we can all start writing. From tomorrow, we can all start writing, right? And hopefully create our music.
Yes, this is a very this is an excellent toolkit. I'm loving this lion thing specifically, and the concept of this thing. If you want to emphasize the words, it should be towards the end. I'm just making notes of this thing.
Yeah, yes. Very true. Okay, Kronaji, it is already fantastic. I mean, again, as Nitin said, Sarang, do you have any comments?
Yeah, this is fantastic. I think this was the key. Like this should be the key for every new writer to know.
Absolutely. In fact, Mr. Khurana is running a journalism school, online journalism school. He probably charges a lot. Unfortunately, it is only in Hindi, I suppose. But he is very kind enough to do this for free for us. Okay. I'm moving on.
Always there, sir. Yeah.
Okay. I'm moving on, Mr. Khurana. Thanks a lot. Please. Now, okay. So we have gotten this, right? You know, etymology and writing music, emphasis, lion, we have all of these things. And I have taken time to write this. And one article I have written, and you know, it has taken me a day, two, I have revised it, and I've done this. Now, next week, when I come and sit and write, I am like, whatever I have said, I have to say, I have said it. It's over. So how do you keep, you have been writing column every week, you have been writing for years. How do you keep your idea coming and flowing all the time?
Two things. One is every one of us goes to movies. We watch movies. What a movie is, it's a love story. There is a hero, there is a heroine, there is a villain. But every movie is different, despite being a love story. It is the presentation, the way you present, the way you structure your things also gives a new dimension to your articles. One particular idea, you can talk about that particular idea in different ways. This is one thing. Second thing is, as I said, in the Loyan formula, if you innovate, you group things, you ungroup things, you bundle and you unbundle. And this is how you innovate. So that's also a way of coming up with new ideas. And learning is always there. Inputs are always there. New situations come. New events come. You go to new seminars. You meet new people. You learn new things. So it is not difficult if we are alert. It is only mental alertness that makes you successful as a writer. You can write any number of... Sejal now says she's writing single day. Every single day. So she's coming up with new ideas, new things every single day, and she's being noticed already. It is not that she will be noticed in future. She's being noticed already. So it is not difficult. It is only a mental block when we say we can't come up with new ideas. It is only mental alertness that gives us new ideas.
I think Sejal has 5,000 followers in LinkedIn already.
She is a celebrity already.
Now, okay, so what you said is the innovate and all of those things, and yes, we meet people. Say for example, we are coming into this particular forum, we have understood, we are talking to you, okay, and we have taken some notes, okay, so there is something new. Maybe tomorrow morning we all can go to LinkedIn and put in and say, hey, these are the things that we learned from Mr. Khurana. I hope, you know, all of you who are here, Sarang, Nitin, Sejal, I don't know whether Mr. Ramtula is there in LinkedIn, and Sanobar and Jagan, all of you will post it. But what are the tools? Do you have any apps to capture this, or is it all only, say, for example, your pen and note? Do you have any app? Have you moved to digital? What are the tools? What are the apps that you use? to capture this information and process this information and continue to write?
I'll give you a simple tool. Rather, instead of going that technology geek kind of a thing, you are a technology geek, you can do all those things. For a layman of my stature, for a layman of my person who knows only the spelling of technology, nothing beyond that, I use an Excel sheet. And it was my good fortune that I attended a webinar when the lockdown was there, and it was a TEDx speech. So I was, attended that webinar, the speaker said, "You are learning something new from this event today. I believe you have been attending other webinars also or live seminars in the past. Do you remember any of them? Do you remember the points discussed or raised by the speaker? If you have not, you have forgotten. And if you have forgotten, you've just wasted your time. So instead of just listening, make it a practice of journaling. Make an Excel sheet and write down all the points that you learned over there. And keep on adding to that Excel sheet, writing down whatever you learned in the news event, meeting with new people, learning with new things, or reading new books. A webinar is almost equal to 1,000 books, because the person who's speaking as TEDx speaker, 30 years experience, 40 years experience, and he boils down the entire experience of his lifetime experience, he gives you in half an hour or 1 hour. So if you keep on jotting down all those points and keeping revisiting them, so this is a simple process. You don't need, if you have an app, if that helps you, far better. If you don't have an app, if you are a person of like me who's technology illiterate, you can use a simple Excel sheet or even Word format. You can keep on writing and make just one simple file where you keep on adding the new information. And whenever you revisit that page, you will come up with new ideas, new things, and it will clear your thought process. It will give you new insights always. And a human mind is such, if we don't within 24 hours, we lose 80% of the information. And within 1 week, we lose the entire thing. So it is required that you revisit the things you... That's why there are refresher courses in corporate life also. We've been in corporate life where we undergo the refresher courses or various webinars, seminars. It is because our mind is such that it unclutters itself automatically. And uncluttering is, it forgets the things you've learned in the past. Unless it has gone to your subconscious mind and active there, unless it is in your practice, in your daily practice, you will forget. So it is better to have either a Word format or Excel sheet or whichever form you want. Just keep on jotting down the ideas and revisiting.
Wonderful. So I'm going back to the, you started like this, when we started this conversation, that I am not academically very trained and all of that, but just when we are talking about this etymology, emphasis principle, it's a writing music, writing is a music. I mean, that's nothing but training. So I don't know what you would call yourself as, I'm not academically trained, but this is what it is, right? And it is very true that you said, like, you know, a TEDx speaker, it might be just 30 minutes of speaking, but he or she is bringing in whatever they have read in 30, 40 books, plus their own lifetime experience. And, you know, you are doing that with us. All your experience, all that you've learned from various sources. It's our good fortune as well. So thanks a lot for that. Okay. So these are all there. So I want to dig a little further. Before you write, do you have any kind of a routine, anything to declutter your mind, or meditation, or any other routine at all? Maybe you write something for 5 minutes before you write seriously? Is there any routine at all that you have to continuously to write?
I meditate, but it doesn't contribute only to my writing. It contributes to my life. So meditation has far deeper impact on my life. I meditate daily in the morning. So that's a different thing. For writing, I just think what kind of topic I want to write today, and then I simply start writing. And when I start writing, ideas come and I give them a start. I don't think beforehand. Rather, my thing clears my mind. Maybe it is different people. Somebody can have a first or jot down the pointers first. Somebody will do it that way. I do it in a different way. I start writing, things keep on coming to my mind, and structure comes up automatically.
You know,
maybe it is because of the long experience I have in writing. I don't need to have pointers first. Maybe.
But what you say,
sir? You were saying.
Yeah, I was listening to Stephen King, the popular novelist, and he says something similar to what you said.
Okay.
You know, when I start thinking about a novel, I have a very vague idea about a character, about the theme of the novel, very vague idea. But when I start writing, that is when the character develops and the plot develops.
Yes.
And I keep writing. And, you know, I don't stop. I keep writing. And in a day, I write probably like, he's a novelist, right? So he writes for 6-7 hours. And when I started the novel, maybe the plot was something. And as I write and I continue, when I finish, probably the plot is entirely different. Yeah. So,
I may start with a different idea, but when it gets developed, it sometimes is altogether a different idea and far better an idea.
So all that I can say is I will, at least in my mind, I'm going to put you on the same plane as Stephen King.
You are very kind.
Anybody else has any questions?
So I want to actually make a comment here, and this actually aligns with what Joseph, you have also been telling in your Gravitas course regarding journaling your learning.
Yes.
So when you start writing what you are learning and you keep revisiting, that gives you more ideas, more opportunities, and then it also not only declutters your mind, possibly give you, as you said, it gives you more opportunities to think better and then go back and write it out. So what Kuranjali also mentioned, he also mentioned that, okay, fine. If you attend webinar, okay, just write about it, okay, journal it. That's where I learn. And that is possibly a key of possibly gaining insights and writing better.
Very true, very true.
Yeah.
Very true. Thanks, Nitin. And for me also, writing is thinking. It is not, writing comes after thinking. I think with writing. So it's a fantastic tip that you are given. So now you have this long career. You have written so many articles, so many things that you also written a book. Can you talk to me about the book that you have written, sir?
Yes, sir. The book is on the Indian governance system. It is in Hindi. And the title of the book is Bhartiya Loktantra Shashan Ke Kuch Anchhue Pehlu, Samasyaen Aur Samadhan. So I'm talking in that book about the constitution amendments that have made our country a banana republic. Now I'll give you some insights into the book since you mentioned it. Otherwise, it is not at all a political thing, but I will mention the constitution amendments. And the amendments have been done by all the parties. It is not just one party. So it is not a political at all. Now I will give you one simple thing. You as a citizen, when you go for voting, you can vote for any of the candidates you like. From any party or independent candidate, you can vote for that. Nobody can pressurize you unless you have some vested interest. If someone has vested interest, then it's altogether a different story. But as an independent voter, nobody can force you to vote for somebody. You have your free will. But the moment a person gets elected, whether he is a corporator, mayor, MLA, or MP, he or she cannot vote as per his free will.
Yes.
Constitution amendment says there is a whip, and because of the whip, you to vote according to the party line. Whatever party has decided, you cannot go against that whip. And if you go against that whip, you will be disqualified. You won't be the member of the house after that. The president of the party can expel you. So the effect of that is that an MLA and MP knows that he cannot vote as per his conscience. So they are not interested in the debate in the parliament or in the legislative assembly. The level of the debates has come down drastically. One thing, because of this, it has led to voice voting. Voice voting means they raise hand and say aye if they support the bill, and they say no if they oppose the bill. Anybody from the opposition party will say no. Anybody from the ruling party will say aye, say yes to the bill. So even before voting, we know what is the result. So voting has no practical relevance at all. And because of that, the next implication is that it is the Lok Sabha record. I'm referring to the Lok Sabha record that 15 bills were passed in 5 minutes. A bill that consists of, say, 300 pages and 15 bills, 4,500 pages, they read all those pages, made up their opinion, and they voted either for it or against it. You can think of the situation we are living in. So, number one. Number two, since the opposition doesn't have numbers, it cannot prevent a bill from being passed. Whosoever is in opposition cannot prevent a bill for being passed, and they cannot get it amended also. And the ruling party, if I am a member of the ruling party and if I am not a minister, if I bring up a bill, if I table a bill, it will still be considered as a private bill. And no private bill has ever been passed in Indian Parliament for last 50 years. Last half century, not even one single bill has been passed. One single private bill has been passed. It means whatever bill is being brought by the government will only be passed. And whatever bill government brings will automatically be passed. Why do we need 543 MPs then? So let's conclude this discussion, because this is not a political forum. I understand that, but
no. Sarang, you have a question. Do you want to ask it?
Yeah. So getting more insights on writing, I usually keep a track of a key indicator whenever I do something. So okay. I just want to know if there is any key indicator to watch for when you write. For an example, like when you go to a gym, you usually keep on checking your weight, or when I usually cycle, I usually keep a track of my distance and time. So is there something to check in terms of writing?
Yeah. So I would say when I write, I don't know about others, but when I write, I use not only these familiar words, but also simple words. I will like to give an example in Hindi. There is a word saral, saral. It doesn't have any matra. It doesn't have any vowel at all. It is so simple. But in talking and in writing, you never say saral. You always say asan. Though asan has vowels, two vowels, still asan is prevalent. Asan is prachalit. Asan is traditional. So when I write, I will like to use asan instead of using saral. So there is a joke which we used to hear when we were children, that a learned man went to a new city. He wanted to go to the university and he asked a rickshaw puller to take him to Vishwavidyalaya. The rickshaw puller kept on circling the city and he didn't take him to the university. And then he said in an angry tone, "You can't take me to the university. What kind of a rickshaw puller you are?" Then he said, "Sir, you were talking in English. I am an illiterate person. I don't know English. How could I understand what you are saying when you said Vishwavidyalaya? Now you are talking in Hindi and saying university. I can take you to the university." So we should use the words that are prevalent, that are easily understandable, and that are being used in common language. So whenever you want to write, keep it a principle. What I do is, suppose I want to write something, I think like I'm sitting in a restaurant with one of my friends. I'm explaining the concept to my friend. And the words I will use to explain that concept will come in my article. So my article is never bookish. This is one principle I use. And this has helped me a lot. This is how I've been more popular among all other columnists that are there in the papers I write.
That's a very good thing. I mean, I think this ties to the previous tip that you also gave, that you should know your audience and use their language rather than showing off your academic qualifications and everything. So. This is a very good. So imagine having a conversation in a restaurant and then write that.
Yes.
That's a pretty, very, very valid thing. Mr. Jagan, you have a question?
Yeah. So one question I had was, I'm a person who writes in a Twitter style, right? More than not 6-7 sentences, but to explain two things, you might need only half a page or one page, right? How do you really expand the thought, make it really compelling, right? Because there is one step, Gordon type of writing, the other is like Ben Thompson, who writes an article for about a few pages, right? So I just thought of getting good insight on how to expand and make the article more interesting. Yeah.
I'm also on Twitter. What I do is I use a simple technique over there, because there is a limitation of words. We cannot go beyond a certain number of words over there or certain number of characters over there. So if I want to write something which is bigger, then I create a JPG thing of that and attach it with my note over there and explain it in the text. So that helps me make my idea clear to my audience.
I think Sajal also had a similar question to what Mr. Jagan asked. Sajal, do you want to ask that question?
Yeah, I will actually. See, the thing is, there's a lot of type of content, but then there's two kind of content. One is boring, that's written in textbooks, because it's, and students are, you know, we are supposed to read it because that's the curriculum. There's another kind of content that basically speaks to the audience, and the audience is pulled towards that kind of content. So one thing that, one, I wouldn't say I struggle with it. No, I do not struggle, but that is something I, you know, have questions time to time. Is this content engaging enough? Does it speak to the audience? So, you know, at the end of the day, I need a good reach for my content because that motivates me. Plus, it, again, it's necessary. So how do you make engaging content, and how do you ensure that the content speaks to the audience? Are you able to understand my question?
I think I have understood your question. I don't know whether I have really understood or not, but I would like to answer it as far as my kabliyat goes. What I do is, I have already explained to you the emphasis principle. I have already explained to you the music principle. And I have already explained to you the grouping, bundling, and unbundling principle. Now, if you have a thesaurus, you can use multiple words for same idea. It engages the readers. And since you are very good at language, I know you already are, so it should not be difficult for you to rewrite the sentences in different words and keeping the audience engaged. It is using different words for the same idea. So this is, since I write in Hindi, I can give you an example. For being arrogant, I say kadiyal hona adiyal hona bahut zyada faydemand nahi hai. You can do it in English. You can do it in other languages as well. So these two words create music. These two words make me express better. And these two words keep the audience engaged. This is a very simple, usual example.
Thank you.
Second thing is, I would like to add one more thing. When opening of the article, if you use phrases instead of the full sentences, it will catch, it will become a feature kind of a thing instead of an article. So suppose if a singer has come and you are reporting that event, you will say, stadium mein lighten jal rahi thi. Full stop. Iski jagah pe aap kahoge, stadium lighton se jagmagaya. Full stop. Instead of jag rahi thi, aap pura sentence nahi likhoge. Then you will say, complete silence. Puri tarah se chuppi. Full stop. You are not writing the full sentence. You are using the phrases to explain what is over there. Phir, sadhe kadmon se unka aana. Full stop. Start singing. Full stop. Mesmerizes the audience. Full stop. Clapping. Full stop. So, matlab aap chote chote टुकड़ों में एक सेंटेंस को आपने 6-7 टुकड़ों में बांट दिया. यू डिवाइडेड द फुल सेंटेंस इनटू 5-6 पैटर्न्स एंड दिस इज हाउ यू एक्सप्रेस योरसेल्फ. इट बिकम्स अ फीचर काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग दैट एंगेजेस योर ऑडियंस बेटर.
वंडरफुल. आई थिंक द सेकंड वन दैट यू टॉक्ड अबाउट विल मेक सेंस अ लॉट मोर इन सोशल मीडिया एंड इन लिंक्डइन एंड आई एम गोना यूज दैट. I'm going to use that, not the full sentence, but so Nitin or anybody see me writing phrases, you know who is the culprit. Okay, we have talked for an hour. Thanks a lot, as you are always, you know, very gracious with your time, and we can continue to talk for a long, but people are already dropping off saying I have a next meeting. I'm very sorry to drop off.
Yes.
I'm very thankful to your gracious, you know, graciously spending time with us. Thank you very much. Thanks for supporting me. So where can people be in touch with you? How can they know you more?
This is a very relevant question. I would like to now answer it in your technological kind of answer you say. So anybody in the universe is just 6 layers away from you. Even if you want to reach out to Trump or to Joe Biden, you can find out a person who knows another person and who knows another person who knows Joe Biden. So that is one thing. Second thing is, you can go to Google. You can Google and you can find anybody in the universe. Plus, I have a website called www.pkkhurana.com. Simple. pkkhurana.com. That is my website. You can reach me. Anybody can reach out to me. Then I'm on Twitter, pkpedia. pkaypedia. So it is derived from Wikipedia. I made it pkpedia. And I'm on Facebook also. I'm on LinkedIn also. So Facebook also, pkkhurana 94 is the link for the reaching out to me there. But best is you reach out to me via the website. It is far more easier. If you forget some time, I will give you a simple thing. It is 8 p.m. now. All Punjabis are PK. You just need to remember Kirana.
Very simple. And as always, it is always very, very engaging and jovial. It's like having a conversation, right? So that's how it has to be. And Kronaji, I'm very, very thankful for supporting these webinars.
It's a pleasure.
And I have learned a lot. I'm sure others learned as well. And thanks a lot. Thank you very much.
I would like to just add one thing about my journalism workshop. Thing is, in India, you go to any college, any university, they will teach you journalism. They will make you a journalist. If you go to a newspaper and do internship, they will make you a journalist. They do that. I go beyond that. When I hold workshops, I tell people, if you have the skill set of a journalist, you can be a homepreneur, a journalpreneur, and you have the option of these 15, 16 kinds of businesses that you can run from your home without investing anything. So what I do is I don't teach journalism alone, but I teach being journalpreneur, how one can monetize his skill as a journalist. I'll give you one simple example. There used to be a lady in Dainik Bhaskar in Chandigarh. She shifted to Mumbai and she contacted me. I gave her an idea. Aap Punjab ki film industry ko jante ho bahut achi tarah se. You are very well connected with the singers, actors, directors, producers over here. Why don't you create a website in Hindi that talks about the Punjabi cinema? So the website is in Hindi. It is for Hindi audience, but it talks about the Punjabi cinema. So after that, she added Gujarati cinema. After that, she added South cinema. So her website got popular immediately. This is just one example. There are hundreds of examples. You see, there is a Samosa Junction. What they did, they came up with 20 variations of samosa. There is Cafe Coffee Day. They came up with 250 variations of coffee. So it is only using your imagination and monetizing your idea. I give them the ideas how they can monetize if they are a journalist, if they know how to write better. Simply, if you can write better, you can monetize your idea. This is what I do.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much. And good luck to you. And we will continue to have you in future sessions.
It's a pleasure, sir, talking to you always. You are a very good mentor, and I have learned so many things from you as well. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks, Joseph.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Welcome.